Hello everyone. Today we will be discussing about the differential diagnosis of various conditions involving the right iliac fossa. Discussing about the organs present in the right iliac fossa are the appendix, the cecum, the ileocecal junction or the ileocecal valve, right ureter, and right ovary and right fallopian tube in females. Let us begin with appendix. The pathological condition involved in appendix is appendicitis, which is the inflammation of the appendix, which also involves the greater omentum and the cecum. The symptoms involve colicky pain initially around the umbilicus but later localized to the right iliac fossa, and on coughing and on sudden movement the pain in the right iliac fossa is exacerbated. Nausea and vomiting, pyrexia of mild grade, abdominal tenderness, increased pulse rate, neutrophilic leukocytosis. The patients may also complain as abdominal pain which is shifting in nature. Investigations may involve ultrasound, X-ray and MRI. Let us talk about the examination for appendicitis. The cardinal features are those of an unwell patient with low-grade pyrexia, localized abdominal tenderness, muscle guarding and rebound tenderness. Inspection of the abdomen may show limitation of respiratory movement in the lower abdomen. The patient is then asked to point whether the pain began and where it moved. Gentle superficial palpation in the abdomen beginning in the left iliac fossa and moving anticlockwise to the right iliac fossa will detect the muscle guarding over the point of maximum tenderness, which is classically known as McBurney's point. Moving on to perforated peptic ulcer as another differential diagnosis. What is a perforated peptic ulcer? In a perforated peptic ulcer, the duodenal contents may pass along the paracolic gutter to the right iliac fossa. So there is a history of dyspepsia and a very sudden onset of pain that starts in the epigastrium and passes down the right paracolic gutter. Investigations to confirm may involve erect chest radiograph, which may show gas under the diaphragm in almost 70% of the cases. Other investigation may involve computed tomography, that is CT scan of the abdomen. Tumors of appendix may involve carcinoid tumor, which is the most common tumor, pseudomyxoma peritonei and adenocarcinoma. The clinical features involve flushing diarrhea, bowel obstruction, hernias and feeling of fullness. Moving on to another organ present in the right iliac fossa is the cecum. Talking about CA cecum, which is the most common pathology, on palpation we feel a nodular hard mass. On percussion, we may feel impaired resonance, that is usually resonance should be felt in the cecum, which is a tubular organ, but it is not felt, that is impaired resonance. The clinical features involve unexplained pain in the right iliac fossa. Mass doesn't move with respiration. The mass is mobile, but the mobility gets restricted once it adheres to the psoas muscle. The features of intestinal obstruction might be present. These involve bloating, constipation, nausea, vomiting, and pain while defecation. Moving on to ileocecal junction, the most common pathology is ileocecal tuberculosis due to the presence of Peyer's patches and its close affinity. The clinical features involve abdominal pain, anemia, weight loss, loss of appetite, diarrhea, and fever. Moving on to psoas abscess. What is a psoas abscess? It is a cold abscess due to tuberculosis of the thoracolumbar spine T10. It is a localized, smooth, soft, non-mobile mass. The caseating pus from the vertebrae gravitates underneath the psoas muscle via the medial arcuate ligament. The clinical features involve spinal tenderness and restricted spinal movements, limp, anorexia, nausea, weight loss and malaise along with right iliac fossa pain. Moving on to right ovaries and right fallopian tube. Right ovarian torsion may be present, which may manifest as nausea, severe pelvic pain, vomiting, fever and abnormal bleeding. Hemorrhage in the right ovarian cyst, vaginal bleeding that may be offensive, fatigue, vomiting, feeling faint, fever and painful urination are the symptoms of hemorrhage. Ectopic pregnancy is another common differential diagnosis, which may manifest as vaginal bleeding, dizziness, fainting, syncope and shoulder tip pain, which is a very characteristic pain. Moving on to the signs, The pelvic, abdominal and adnexal tenderness or fullness is felt at the right iliac fossa. Signs of peritonism may also be present. Cervical motion tenderness, that is pain on moving the cervix, is present, and tachycardia and hypotension may be the additional features. Right ureter. Right ureteric colic can also be one of the differential diagnoses, which may manifest as intense pain along the sides of the body, pain that spreads from the back to the groin, which is a very characteristic shifting pain, nausea and vomiting. Investigations may confirm ureteric colic, which may involve urine analysis and shows presence of red cells and renal ultrasound. The other organs or differential diagnosis of the right iliac fossa pain may be ectopic or transplanted kidneys, undescended testis and tubo-ovarian or adnexal mass. As the image shows, this is ectopic kidney and this is a TO mass. Thank you.